Encrypting your hard drive. It sounds like some sort of super complicated process that involves hours of coding and mathematical calculations just to protect your data. And you might also think that if you do it, it would be somehow difficult to ever access that data because it's, well, encrypted. But in reality, encrypting your hard drive is pretty easy, and in most cases, if you do it, you won't even notice any difference in how you use your computer. And there are actually a few different options that you have if you want to do it, based on both software and hardware, so that's what we're going to talk about today. So first of all, why would you want to encrypt your hard drive anyway? What are the pros and the cons? Well, the main reason is very straightforward, you can probably guess it already, which is that when you encrypt your hard drive, the data is safe if anyone were to physically steal your computer. You see, how it works is when you first encrypt the drive, obviously all your data is encrypted with a key and obfuscated with whatever key you choose. So if anyone were to take that drive out or try to boot up without the password, they wouldn't have any of the data. It would all just look like nonsense. But then how are you supposed to use the drive? Well, the software that you use to encrypt the drive will encrypt and decrypt the data on the fly so the operating system doesn't have to worry about it. So when the operating system needs a certain piece of data, the software will read it off the drive, decrypt it first, and then feed it to the operating system. And when the operating system wants to write something to the disk, again, the software will encrypt it before putting it on the drive. So really, your computer will look and feel exactly the same as it did before. Of course, if you need to encrypt and decrypt this data on the fly all the time, you are going to get some performance loss from the overhead. Anytime you need to read or write something, it takes a bit of processing power to do so. But depending on your computer power, this might not even be noticeable at all. But still, depending on your situation, it might not be worth it. But there is a hardware option that has basically zero overhead, and we'll get into that in a bit. You also have to take into consideration the difficulty in setting up the disk encryption in the first place based on the different options. With a laptop, for example, I really think it's absolutely essential to encrypt your hard drive simply because you're so much more likely to have it stolen or lose it. But for a desktop, probably a lot less likely to get it stolen, though I still think, I guess it is possible, I suppose. So let's talk about software encryption first. I think for most people, the best option would just be to use the encryption feature built right into Windows called Bitlocker. It might not be the absolute most secure options, but it's certainly good enough. I mean, for most people, they just want to worry about not having their data stolen by a common thief or something like that. I think if the government wants your data and they steal your laptop, you're kind of screwed. But it is probably the easiest method, BitLocker. And with BitLocker, to encrypt the drive, you basically just have to go into the options in Windows and enable the feature, then follow the prompts, and it does all the work for you. You choose a password, it gives you a backup key file in case you forget it, and then it automatically encrypts the drive. And you can even keep using the computer while it does so, because again, it's all on the fly. Then, the only difference you'll notice from then on is that you have to boot up the computer and type in an extra password, or depending on your settings, it might just use your Windows password, and then there's basically no difference at all. But I should point out that not everyone will have access to the BitLocker feature because it does have some system requirements. First of all, you need a version of Windows that includes it. These would be Windows 7 Ultimate or Enterprise Editions, Windows 8 Professional or Enterprise, or Windows 10 Professional or Enterprise, or the education version, I believe, as well. The home editions of Windows do not have BitLocker, unfortunately. Also, your computer will need what is called a Trusted Platform Module, or TPM, which is a hardware chip that is part of the computer itself. So if your computer doesn't have one, you're kind of out of luck. It really has to be built in with it. And you technically can enable BitLocker without a TPM, but it's more complicated and difficult than most people watching this video are willing to do, so I'm not going to get into that. The good news is, though, that most modern mid-range and high-end laptops should include a TPM chip. But if you can't use BitLocker, there are other free disk encryption programs like Veracrypt, which will encrypt your whole hard drive, do the same thing, it boots up, you ask for a password, and you can look that up. But showing you how to use that is beyond the scope of this video. Now, what if you don't want to go through all the trouble of using software to encrypt your drive, or you don't want to lose any performance? Well, as I kind of mentioned earlier in the video, there is a hardware option in the form of so-called self-encrypting drives. And these are like the best of both worlds, basically, since they offer pretty much zero loss in performance, but still protect all your data in the same way. A self-encrypting drive is really just like a regular old drive, either a hard drive or SSD, but it usually is a solid-state drive these days, only it's going to have a dedicated chip on it whose job is to self-encrypt data on the fly. So with a self-encrypting drive, instead of relying on software to encrypt or decrypt the data while it's being written to or read, now you have a dedicated component built right into the drive. So this means that you no longer have to use the computer's resources for the job, and therefore no loss in performance. And using it is basically the same. You set a password, then without that password, no one can boot up the computer or access any data on it. But otherwise, it behaves the same as a regular disk drive. So where can you get one of these mysterious self-encrypting drives? Well, you really just have to look for one when you're shopping for a drive. Surprisingly, this feature is not that well advertised even in drives that have them, even though it's super useful, especially for a laptop where losing it is more likely, but also for a desktop since there's basically no downside besides having to type in an extra password. Actually, if you have a high-end SSD, you might actually have the feature already without realizing it. For example, the latest Samsung Pro Series SSDs, such as the 850 Pro or 950 Pro, those are self-encrypting. They have that feature built in. You just need to enable it. But if you were to look at the Newegg product page for these drives, it doesn't even mention encryption anywhere. So unless you were to go to Samsung's website and look at the drive specs there, you wouldn't know. Some things to look for if you are specifically looking for a self-encrypting drive is if the specs mention phrases such as FDE, which stands for full disk encryption, or SED, which stands for self-encrypting drive, or OPAL, which is a drive security specification for self-encrypted drives. If it says OPAL, it probably is self-encrypting. Now, finally, I guess I should go over what encryption will not do for you. It's not magic. So for example, it's not going to stop hackers from reading your data, like if you get a virus, since when the computer is booted up, after you enter the password, the drive behaves like a regular old drive, like I just said, and any data that you can read easily, the virus can as well. What it will do is stop someone from physically accessing your drive if they don't have the password, if the drive is not powered up, like they steal it after it's turned off or something like that. Or I guess if you have the drive networked but not decrypted at the time, they can't access that either, obviously. But the main thing is, if someone steals your computer, the drive is going to be completely useless, assuming you used a very strong password that would take forever to brute force. So as I mentioned several times before, if you're trying to figure out whether or not it's worth it to encrypt your drive, I'd consider it absolutely necessary for a laptop that you take outside your house. You might not think you have anything important on there, but you probably do. For example, do you stay logged into your email on your laptop? Or do you have personal files of any kind on your laptop? There is a good chance these could be used against you without even realizing it if it were to be stolen. So even though your laptop is gone, at least you can rest easy that your data is safe. And a lot of people don't even realize that your phone, like iPhones these days and Android phones, by default enable full phone encryption. So that's why if someone steals it, they can't just plug it in and access all your data without the PIN. Now obviously a PIN number is not exactly super strong for an encryption password, not at all, but most of the time these phones also have brute force countermeasures built in, so it really limits how many times someone can try a password, and then if you type in a password too many times wrong, then it just erases the phone altogether. So there's some countermeasures built into phones. But for your computer, a lot of people, they just don't encrypt it at all, and your data is just there. So even if you have a password on your laptop, but it's not encrypted, it's useless. Someone could just unplug that drive, plug it into a computer. They don't have to worry about that password because they're just looking at the raw data. So I would definitely suggest at least considering encrypting your drive depending on the importance of the data on it. Definitely for a laptop or something like that. Maybe for a desktop if you're in a high-risk area, I guess, but still not a bad idea. So I guess that's it. Hopefully I gave you guys some ideas. I didn't want to get too in-depth and too technical as a tutorial or something like that, but hopefully you guys still enjoy this video. If you did like it, if you could give it a thumbs up, I'd really appreciate it. That'd be great. And also let me know down in the comment section, do you encrypt your drive? Do you not bother, or do you only do it sometimes? Let us know. And also, if you want to continue watching, I'll put some other videos right here. You can click on those even if you're on a phone. And if you want to subscribe, I make new videos every Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday, so it should be worth it. And also consider clicking the bell next to the subscribe button so you can get actual notifications so YouTube will actually show you the new videos. So again, thank you guys for watching, and as usual, I'll see you next time. Have a good one.